हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू स्टैंडर्ड 10 ज्योमेट्री क्लास, चैप्टर 10 सर्कल्स पार्ट 3. सो चिल्ड्रन, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव सीन टू वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थियरम्स और रिजल्ट्स. विच आर दोज? द वेरी फर्स्ट इज रेडियस इज परपेंडिकुलर टू द टेंजेंट एट द पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट. एंड द सेकेंड रिजल्ट वॉज the length of the tangent segments drawn from exterior points to the circle, they are equal in length, right? So now let us continue with our exercise 10.2, which is based on these two theorems. So exercise 10.2, first three questions are MCQ type questions, which are very easy. In previous lesson, we have solved this type of questions. So, I will just give you the hint. You find out its answer and tick the correct option. So, the question is, from a point Q, say in the diagram, which is in the exterior of the circle, the length of the tangent to a circle is 24 centimeters. And the distance of Q from the center is 25 centimeter, then the radius of the circle is. So here Q is an exterior point. So QT distance, this is length of tangent segment, it is 24, and the distance of this point Q from the center is 25 centimeter. So you have to find the radius of the circle, which is length OT. So now children, which theorem is useful here? That the radius is perpendicular to the tangent at the point of contact. That theorem you use. So by that you will get this triangle as a right angle triangle. Apply Pythagoras theorem. Two lengths are given. You can find out the third one and guess the answer. Find the length OT. Right? Now, next. Here. In the figure, if TP and TQ are two tangents to a circle with center O, so that angle POQ is equal to 110 degree, then angle PTQ is equal to. So here angle POQ is given 110, and you have to find measure of angle PTQ. So there are two hidden measures which you have to guess. Can you guess what are those? So here this OP is the radius and TP is the tangent. So radius is perpendicular to the tangent, that means this angle is 90 degree. Similarly, this angle Q is 90 degree. So in this quadrilateral OPTQ, what is the angle sum property of a quadrilateral? That sum of all the angles of a quadrilateral is equal to 360 degree. So you apply that property, you know three measures, three angles, 90 plus 110 plus 90. So fourth angle you can calculate very easily. 90 plus 90, 180. 180 plus 110 is equal to 290. So 360 minus 290 is equal to 70. So the correct option is B, 70 degree. So orally you can calculate this. This is very important. This can be asked for 1 mark in the board exam. Question number 3. This is also easy but little bit lengthy. So that is why I have solved and shown to you. If tangents PA and PB from a point P to a circle with center O are inclined to each other at angle of 80 degree, then angle POA is equal to. So the question mark is made here. You have to find out angle POA. So what is given to you? The angle of inclination between two tangent segments which are drawn from the exterior point P. Right? So this total angle is 80 degree. So you have to find the measure of this angle. So like that previous sum, this is 90 degree. This angle B is 90 degree. Why they are 90? By radius, tangent and radius property. That radius is perpendicular to the tangent at the point of contact. So by that property, this is 90, this is 90, and the third one is 80. So you can find out this total angle AOB. Right? So for that, you consider quadrilateral APBO. Sum of all the angles of a quadrilateral is equal to 360 degree. Now substitute the value APB80, which is given to you. PAO is 90 by radius perpendicular to the tangent property. AOB is unknown, that you have to find out, and PBO is again 90 by the same property, that is equal to 360. Their sum is 260. So AOB, this unknown angle, is equal to 360 minus 260, so 100 degree. So this total angle AOB is 100 degree, but we want angle AOP. So let us find out what is the relation between AOB and AOP. So for that, you need to take these two triangles, triangle OAP and triangle OBP. So let us take these two triangles. Here it is. So in these two triangles, this OP is the common side. Right, then angle OAP is equal to angle OBP. Why? They both 90 degree, and OA is equal to OB. Reason? The radii of same circle. So in this way, these two triangles, they are congruent. By which rule? See, OP is the hypotenuse because it is side opposite to 90 degree, and this is one side. So hypotenuse and one side is respectively congruent with the hypotenuse and the corresponding side of the other triangle. So in this way, these two triangles, they are congruent by RHS rule. So triangles are congruent, therefore their remaining sides and angles are also congruent. So by CPCT, you can say angle AOP is equal to angle BOP, right? These two angles are equal. That means this angle POA, this POA angle is exactly half of the total angle, and the total measure is 100. So half of angle AOB, but the angle AOB is of 100 degree. So half of 100 degree is 50 degree. So the correct option is option A, which is 50 degree. Right? So the correct option is option A. Now question number 4. So children, during that points to remember, we have discussed this point that at a time, we can draw at the most two parallel tangents, and they are at the end points of a diameter. So let us prove how the tangents drawn at the ends of the diameters are parallel to each other. So we are going to prove that now. So prove that the tangents drawn at the ends of a diameter of a circle are parallel. So to prove that any two lines are parallel, what are the criteria? Either you have to prove their alternate angles congruent, or corresponding angles congruent, or interior angles supplementary. If any of this three conditions you are able to prove, that means the lines are parallel. So let us see. So in this figure we have this PQ, a diameter, and the end points of this diameter we have drawn two tangents. See, tangent AB and tangent CD. Now we have to prove that these two tangent lines, they are parallel to each other, right? So here OQ is a radius and CD is a tangent. Similarly, OP is a radius and AB is a tangent. So by this property, we know that the tangent at a point to a circle is perpendicular to the radius through the point. So by that property, you will find PQ is perpendicular to AB, and therefore angle APQ is equal to 90 degree. Similarly, this PQ is also perpendicular to CD. So angle PQD, see here PQD, this angle 90 degree. Similarly, angle APQ, this angle is also 90 degree. Reason, radius perpendicular to the tangent. Now, what type of angles are they? But they are alternate angles. So, by converse of alternate angles theorem, we can say AB is parallel to CD. When the alternate angles are congruent, lines are parallel. So AB is parallel to CD. Yes. Now next one. This is very simple. The length of a tangent from a point A at a distance 5 cm from the center of the circle is 4 cm. Find the radius of the circle. That means the length of the tangent segment is 4 cm. Point A is at a distance of 5 cm from the center. You have to find the radius of the circle. This is very much similar to our that MCQ type question, and the values are also very simple. Again, this radius is perpendicular to the tangent at the point of contact. So therefore, triangle OTA is a right angle triangle. Apply Pythagoras theorem. So OA square is equal to OT square plus AT square. Substitute values there. So on substituting, you will get OT square is 5 square minus 4 square. So 25 minus 16, or you can apply identity 5 plus 4, 5 minus 4. So you will get OT square as 9. To get the value of OT, taking square root on both the side, so OT is equal to 3 cm. So thus the radius of the circle is 3 cm. Isn't it easy? So that's all for today's lesson. We will continue with this exercise in our next video lesson. So till then, goodbye and take care.